Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org, and today I want to talk about the most efficient way to update a huge set of database records with Hibernate. If you just want to update one or two entities, you can simply fetch them from the database and perform the update operation on it. But what about updating hundreds of entities? You can, of course, use the standard approach and load and update each of these entities. But that is often too slow because Hibernate performs one or more queries to load the entity and an additional one to update each of them. This quickly results in a few hundred SQL statements, which are obviously slower than just one statement, which lets the database do the work. As I explained in great detail in the Hibernate Performance Tuning online training, the number of performed SQL statements is crucial for the performance of your application. So you better have an eye on the statistics and keep the number of statements as low as possible. You can do that with JPQL or native SQL queries, which define the update in one statement. Using a native update statement is quite easy, as I will show you in the IDE. But it also creates issues with the always activated first level cache and doesn't trigger any entity lifecycle events. I'll show you how to handle these problems at the end of this video. Before we take a look at the native query, let's update the first name attribute of 200 person entities and check how long that takes. I do that in this test case. I get the current time in milliseconds before I load person entities with the ID 0 to 199 and change its first name attribute. And after all of this is done, I flush the current persistence context and get the current time again. You can see here in the session statistics that Hibernate executed 400 queries. These are 200 select and 200 update statements. And overall it took about 1000 milliseconds. Not bad for a laptop and 400 statements. But there's no reason to execute that many SQL statements. You could do the same with just one SQL update statement. You can see that here. I get the current time in milliseconds and call the create native query method on the entity manager with a simple SQL statement that updates the first name of all records with an ID smaller than 200. Then I flush the persistence context and get the time again. This time, Hibernate executed only one query, and as you can see here, that was a lot faster. The native query only took about 1/10 of the time of the previous test. And even so my laptop doesn't provide an ideal environment for a performance test, it's more than obvious which approach is faster. But as so often, you don't get the performance for free. Let's talk about the problems of native bulk operations. The first one is Hibernate's first level cache. Hibernate puts all entities you use within a session into the first level cache. This is pretty useful for write behind optimizations and to avoid duplicate selects of the same entity. But it also creates an issue if you use a native query to update a bunch of entities. Hibernate doesn't know which records the native query updates and can't update or remove the corresponding entities from the first level cache. That means that Hibernate uses an outdated version of the entity if you fetch it from the database before you executed the native SQL update statement. There are two options to avoid this issue. The most obvious one is to not fetch any entity from the database which will be affected by the update statement. But we both know that this is not that easy in a complex modular application. If you can't avoid fetching some of the affected entities, you need to update the first level cache yourself. The only way to do that is to detach them from the active persistence context and let Hibernate fetch it again as soon as you need them. But be careful. Hibernate doesn't perform any dirty check before detaching the entity. So you also have to make sure that all updates are written to the database before you detach the entity. Let me show you how to do that. Here you can see what happens when you don't clear the cache before you run an SQL bulk operation. I first load the person entity with ID 1, then I update all database records and call the entity manager find method again. As you can see here, Hibernate performs a select statement for the first call of the find method and executes the SQL update statement afterwards. But it doesn't execute another select statement for the second call of the find method. Hibernate gets the outdated person entity from the first level cache. You can avoid that if you clear the persistence context before you execute the SQL update statement. That detaches all entities from the persistence context. But always make sure to call the flush method first. That tells Hibernate to write all changes to the database. If you don't do that, you might lose all non-persistent update and insert operations. This time, Hibernate performs a select statement for the second call of the find method. The reason for that is simple. The call of the clear method removed the person entity with ID 1 from the first level cache, and Hibernate needs to get it from the database. So, we do get the better performance of the SQL bulk update statement without having any outdated entities. The second problem is not a huge issue for most applications, but I want to mention it anyways. The native update statement is executed in the database and doesn't use any entities. This provides performance benefits, but it also avoids the execution of any entity lifecycle methods or entity listeners. If you use a framework like Hibernate Inverse, or implement any code yourself that relies on lifecycle events, you have to either avoid native update statements or implement the operations of your listeners within this specific use case. With the standard JPA approach, you fetch an entity from the database and call some setter methods to update it. This feels very natural to Java developers. But the number of required SQA statements can create performance issues if you work on a huge set of entities. It's often a lot faster to update all entities with one native or JPQL update statement. But you then have to take care of your first level cache. Hibernate doesn't know which records were updated in the database and didn't refresh the corresponding entities. You either have to make sure that you haven't fetched any entities which are affected by the update, or you have to detach them from the Hibernate session before you execute the update. You also have to check if you use any entity lifecycle methods or entity listeners. The native update statement doesn't use any entities and therefore doesn't trigger any lifecycle events. If you rely on lifecycle events, you either have to avoid native update statements, or you have to handle the missing lifecycle events within your use case. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!